Frank Warren, sponsored by Hill Dickinson Lawyers, proudly present 12 three-minute rounds for the British and Commonwealth Featherweight Championship, live and exclusive on Sky Sports HD Fight Night Live from the Liverpool Olympia. Your officials are appointed by the Commonwealth Boxing Council and the British Boxing Board of Control, and your three scoring judges at ringside are Mr. Phil Edwards of Preston, Mr. Howard Foster of Doncaster, and Mr. Ian John Lewis of Gillingham. Your steward in charge this evening is Mr. Jeff Bolter. Your timekeeper, the bell, is Mr. Andy East. And when the action begins, your referee in charge is Mr. Victor Loughlin of Paisley in Scotland. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, the challenger, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white shorts, with a record of 10 wins from 11 contests, with 2 wins coming by knockout. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 8 stone, 13 pounds, 7 ounces. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting and introducing from Barry in Wales, the challenger for the title, Lee Selby. And across the ring is a defending champion, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black and gold shorts, weighing in 8 stone, 13 pounds, 1 ounce. He is currently undefeated in 12 professional contests with 6 KOs to his name. Please welcome, from the city of Liverpool, the reigning and defending British and Commonwealth featherweight champion, Stephen Smith. Your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Okay, guys, you've had your instructions in the dressing room. Remember, obey my commands at all time. Defend yourselves at all time. God bless. Touch gloves.
So, 2 titles on the line. British and Commonwealth featherweight titles.
For the British and Commonwealth featherweight championship.
I'm talking to Joe Gallagher in the week, Smith's trainer. He said in many ways he sees this as a harder fight than John Simpson, and he said no disrespect to Simpson, but with John Simpson, he said what you see is what you get fighter. Lee Selby, you just don't know what you're going to get. Well, he's tall, he's very rangy, got those long arms, the Welshman, and the feeling pre-fight is that he is going to box on the outside, try to spoil, keep it at range. And we're talking to Tony Borg, his trainer. They were saying, you know what, we want to try and do something a bit different. Surprise, surprise. We want to try and take the centre of the ring and hold it. And really, it's going to be the first 4 or 5 rounds of this fight. Which one of these guys can establish their game plan that will put themselves in good pole position?
Well, I've been impressed by Selby, the confidence that he's shown, the attitude that we've seen in the lead-up to this. A nice little right hand, just a glancing blow from Smith. But also the whole camp seem up for this. They're putting themselves on the line, saying they're here to win, they expect to win. So this could be a tough little task for the defending champion. He can't go in here tonight thinking he's dropping down a level from John Simpson. He has to treat this seriously. This is a serious, he's a worthy challenger he faces tonight.
Well, that's something else that Selby's going to have to worry about. As you saw Smith come in with a left lead, they got a big cheer from this crowd, and yet it was caught on the glove. They've always got that home advantage because they yell for everything. And sometimes judges can be swayed by that. So Selby really up against it. He's got to put on a really strong, convincing performance and leave this one in no doubt at all if he wants to leave Liverpool with those belts.
He's not keeping Smith off at the moment, Selby, with the punches. He's going to have to find a bit of snap in that jab. It's a long jab, it's quick, but it's not keeping Smith off. Smith just timing the, his counters well, a little bit scrappy up close. But Smith doing a little bit more work in the early stages of the opening round, bullying Selby a little bit, knocking him out of his stride. Selby is a nice boxer, so you don't want to stand off and let him find a rhythm.
Selby, we're just happy to get this first round out of the way, because this, by far, his biggest night. He's loading up with single punches here, the Welshman.
Yep, loading up with big, obvious punches. He's not going to get away with those. I think he feels maybe He's been bullied a little bit and he wants to land a big shot to discourage Smith, but it's a good positive start from Smith. Certainly not dominant. I think his work's been a little bit better, more accuracy. And there's Selby complaining. He's holding up close and he's been thumped in the side of the head by Smith, so he can't really complain about that. He's the one who's holding.
Getting through with a left there. He was very open to a counter if Smith had been able to find something. Another one of those big swinging right hands comes in and misses by a mile. And one of Selby's supposed strength is his accuracy. Well, he hasn't got the radar tuned here at the moment in this first round. But a long, long way to go. Joe Gallagher and Tony Borg in the other corner both saying the same thing to their fighters. You've got to just settle down and calm down a bit. There's a lot of wasted effort in there, and I think that'll come.
Yeah, well, boxing at home is an advantage, but also it may be a little bit of strain involved, certainly in the early stages of fights when you feel you have to please the crowd. I thought it was a decent opening round for Smith.
Tony Borg, Selby's trainer, echoed exactly what you said, Jim, in that first round. He said to his man, he said, don't load up with those single shots, that's not going to work.
Well, Selby didn't box in the opening round in his normal style. So that's a kind of little sign of discomfort, if you like. He was forced into standing, trading, trying to exchange big punches. That's not his game. So he's going to have to try to impose himself, but do it in the way he normally boxes.
They've both had some terrific sparring. The Welshman has been in with his training partner, Gary Buckland, who fights for the British Super Featherweight title next week, and you can see that with us here on Sky Sports. Also, Gavin Reid, the European lightweight champion, and a couple of bigger guys just to keep his concentration. Justin Hughes, Frankie Borg. And of course, as we see, a couple of decent shots go in there and Smith manages to turn it around. Smith gets all that training from the Gallagher gym. And they've brought in some fighters from the Ingle camp as well to try and replicate this guy's awkward style. Good right hand gets in from Selby. Well, the Welshman showing that he's not going to be bullied and intimidated here.
Well, nothing awkward about Selby's style at the moment. He's standing right in front of Smith and trading with him. This is not what the Smith camp would have expected, but I don't think they'll be too upset about it, because if they want to stand off and exchange punches, Smith confident he can do that. We have to remember, Smith's not a kid, he's 26, he's a mature man, and I think it's that maturity that got him through twice against John Simpson.
But this is going the way Tony Borg said it would, that it wasn't going to be hiding and surviving and running and spoiling from Selby. But he's going to come here, he's going to try and take the centre of the ring and really catch Smith by surprise. Well, he might be surprised, but as you say, Jim, Smith is pretty happy to see an opponent stand there in front of him.
Not a lot of accuracy from Smith in the second round. He's been knocked out of his stride a little bit. Maybe just not expecting, you know, the standing and the trading that he's seen from Selby.
There's a left hand landed there from Smith.
Just a little bit messy in the second round, just both a little bit over-anxious to land big punches.
Oh, nice, drew him in nicely there, Smith, and landed a left to the body. Nice little feint.
I think Selby's wasting a lot of punches, winding them up and wasting them.
But that's a good one. Big right hand from Selby. And he just went winging in, trying to find another one. And lost his accuracy, but that right hand is a warning for Smith. And Selby knows he's hurt him.
Yep, and he's trying to follow up, digging in the left hook afterwards. Big shot from Selby. He's been looking for that shot, I think, from the opening bell.
Well, there's a big warning sign for the double champion.
Well, I didn't feel we saw the accuracy from Smith in the early part of the opening round, and then the longer the round went, Selby seemed to find a little bit more confidence, and then the big punch that he's been looking for since the fight started, there we see it, and he tried to follow up with a left hook afterwards. So good work from Selby, which maybe just nicked him the round.
Tony Borg, Sanagar on the left there, Sanagar just outside the ropes, his manager, and they're all saying the same thing, stop swinging, because after he landed that big right hand, he went very crude and lost all his accuracy, and that is one of Selby's real strengths. It's a surprise to see him coming out with these big roundhouses.
I mean, you do have to say, I don't think Selby will land any more cleanly than that, and it didn't even budge at Smith. So he really is hard as nails. young Stephen Smith. Is that right hand
through from Selby. Well, there's not too many knockouts and stoppages on Selby's record, but the two that have come have been in the last three fights he's had, and one of them was against James Ancliffe, the Scotsman who's as tough as they come.
This is
and
good
he's starting
stuff.
To unload here.
This is good stuff from Selby. A little bit rubbing the inside of the glove and Smith's face up close to making these tensions. His intentions, obviously, but he's letting the big punches go, and Smith not dealing with them.
And getting off first as well. This is not going according to the script. And it's a more measured round from Selby at the moment as well. He's picking his shots.
Smith not using his skills. He's just trying to blaze back without thinking there's a right hand. Thumping again, maybe a hint of the inside of the glove, but a thumping punch nevertheless.
Body shot. Selby lands an uppercut as well.
I mean, Selby is so obvious in what he's doing, yet Smith is not dealing with it. I mean, you can see what's coming, but they're still landing.
And another right hand, and no movement at all from Smith. No head movement, no lateral movement at all. And he's getting involved in a real war here, Smith.
I think that the macho has taken over in Smith. Look, you can see where Selby winding up the right hand. You know exactly what's coming, and he's still finding the target with it.
Yeah, that last big right hand they saw from the back of the hall, and Selby just unloaded on a static opponent. And Smith's getting close and brawling and spoiling, but not doing any work at all.
Yeah, and wasting a lot of energy in the process. Well, we wondered how much Selby fancied the job and much confidence he had. Well, we know now. Tremendous performance so far.
Good little dig with the left to the body there from Selby as well. Plenty of variety in his work. And he's cut down the big swinging howitzers, as he's been told to, and concentrated more on accuracy. And it's had an effect in this third round. Selby's best round by far. Gets caught coming in there when he wasn't accurate. And again.
Left hook more from Selby.
And teeing off first every time. And just outworking and outscoring the champ, and gets another good left hook in there as well.
I mean, Smith's walking through these punches from the early stages, but you can't keep doing that. I mean, these punches sap energy over the 12-round distance. Tremendous round. Selby winning it for me.
Other brother Paul, of course, is up next as he looks to get back into British title contention. So he's watching on our monitors that we've set up there as well. And I think all three brothers know that Stephen Smith is in a bit of a battle here against a guy that has settled down after a very, very tight and tense first round and has landed some good shots. That's been the good news for Selby. The bad news is Smith has walked through everything he's landed.
Yeah, but over the 12-round distance, you can't continue to take these big punches.
Another one comes in. That's another good left hook. But he's missing there again, Selby. He just needs to stay cool. Stay focused, pick the shots, but there's not a lot coming from Smith. A lot of spoiling and mauling going on from the champion, and Victor Loughlin being quite generous with him at the moment.
Selby just not allowing Smith to use the skills. You know, it's just a kind of macho approach. Every punch he throws, trying to finish the job. Smith really has to start using the skills, put a bit more thought into what he's doing, because this fight is going Selby's way.
Good right hand comes through again from Selby. He follows up with another left hook. Smith walks through him and lands a right of his own, but he takes another left hook for his pains, then another right cross to the body.
Well, Selby is not thinking about the 12-round distance. He's not even bothered about pacing himself here. He's putting everything into every punch, still looking fresh and strong, but a long time to go. Not a good shot.
Well, they say he's in fantastic shape, Selby. He had that fight for the Celtic title against James Ancliffe in July, and this opportunity came up almost immediately afterwards, so he's been pretty much in training since the summer, so he should be in terrific shape.
I think Smith is far too easy to hit for Selby. The left hook to the right hand. I mean, he's telegraphing what he's doing, but still getting the punches home.
There's a right hand landed from Smith that got everybody excited, but Selby's fought him off.
but I still feel Selby's punches are landing the more cleaner of the two. Smith still catching shoulders on the top of the head. Not clean work.
A little left through there, a sharp left. It'll be interesting to see the punch stats in this one, because both of them have missed a lot.
Selby thumping the punches home again. Another close round. Can't believe he's telegraphing that right hand and still getting it home.
Good right to the body from Selby. And so far, I think he's defying expectation here that he's able to stand and trade with Smith. I don't think many people thought he'd be able to do that. They thought he'd be boxing and moving.
Well, as long as he feels he's taking as much out of Smith as he's taken out of himself, he can continue with these tactics. Smith still looking very strong, not producing his best form. I still think Selby has landed the better punches again in this round. But is he taking too much out of the tank?
All right.
Both these fellas working so hard, but they're missing with some frequency as well. As you can see, the success percentage is both in the high teens. Selby slightly more successful and landing more shots as well.
You'll have to give Selby a couple of points up. I just think he's landing the better shots, the shots that you remember. Smith kind of glancing blows, cupping round the side when they're up close, but not the quality that's required here.
Well, Joe Gallagher, Smith's trainer, said the first four or five rounds are going to be crucial. Who can establish their game plan? At the moment, at a conservative estimate, you'd have to say Lee Selby is at least holding his own. There is an argument to say that the Welshman, the big underdog here, is actually having things his own way a little bit, as Smith gets in and gets close again and tries to spoil and hold and just wear his man down.
I think Smith's come in tonight expecting an opponent he's going to have to go looking for. Everything planned on the front foot, chasing for openings, and it's quite the opposite. Selby has come straight at him, stood straight in front of him, thrown everything at him.
Just as Tony Borg said he would. Smith gets his first little warning from Victor Loughlin. Still looking at Lambo's chopping right hands, the Welshman. But Smith's starting to see those a little bit better now.
Selby holding a little bit up close, grabbing hold of Smith's gloves, but he's doing it in the blind side.
Good right hand from Selby. It landed clean and Smith didn't wobble.
Smith comes back with one. I just wonder if the physical strength of Smith will be the deciding factor in this. He still does look a little bit stronger. He's not producing his best form, but still looking really strong.
And you wonder if at the back of Selby's mind he's thinking, I've hit him with some really good shots and I haven't even slowed him down. Is that going to start to worry him? Is fatigue, as you said earlier, Jim, going to start to be a factor later on? Because Smith is just bulldozing his way through and giving Selby no room to work.
Selby just a little bit disjointed at the moment. Yep, Smith looking strong, looking purposeful, not seeing the quality as yet. But he's making an impression, which was badly needed.
Good little left to the body from Selby. And there again, once again, he's spoiling and tying up his man here, Smith, and just trying to drain his reserves of energy. That's better from Selby. And Smith soaks it up and comes back with a reply of his own. And you're getting into battle of wills territory here. Who can establish their mental authority over each other? Bit of a mark under the left eye of Stephen Smith.
Yeah, well, I thought maybe things were beginning to turn a little bit against Selby, but he's proved his character. He's coming straight back into it again. Tremendous round here.
It's a real war of attrition. Another good combination there from Selby. Smith doesn't even feel it. And he teed up that right hand and delivered. And again, no response from Smith. Selby's hitting with everything, and Smith is still standing.
Well, the first couple of minutes or so, it looked as though Smith's strength was beginning to show itself and make an impact, and then Selby come blazing back in the last minute. tremendous battle. Another round so tough to split them.
Can Selby keep this up? Can he stay with Smith? Will Smith be able to wear his man down? Joe Gallagher was saying he had split loyalties tonight because another one of his fighters, Anthony Crawler, is in action in Las Vegas around 11 o'clock our time. And he said he decided to stay with the guy who had the tougher task, that's Smith. Well, he's got a real handful here. And he walks onto another one of those right hands.
I mean, these punches are not having an immediate effect, but over the 12 rounds, you can't keep taking these punches. Tremendous punching again from Selby.
And even if he does survive against Selby, what are his defences going to be like against a big hitter, Smith? He can't take shots like this against a real power puncher, surely.
Well, I think he's got more to worry about tonight than what's going to happen in the future, because his titles are on the line here and there's signs they could be slipping away. He's just lunging in, Smith. Where is the skill and the techniques he learned as an amateur? He's just jumping at Selby, just trying to do it the hard way. Look at the big right hand again from Selby, digging in the shots.
It's been crude from Smith, but he's still banging away. And Selby out punching him. But Smith just not giving an inch.
Well, it's an old cliche, but I think this is just going to go down to who can just dig in that bit more, who wants it a little bit more. Because this is not really about skill, this is just about desire, strength, toughness and will to win. Selby looking over at his corner there, which is never a great sign.
And we know Smith can go 12 rounds like this. He did it against Simpson, but another terrific shot from Selby. And how much more of this can Smith take?
But this is another round, tough to score, but I think Selby's landing the better punches.
You can't take your eyes off this for a second. Smith lunges in and scores first, and that hasn't happened too often. And Selby just looking a little bit weary, like he felt that one.
Well, Smith. Selby probably the one looking for a little breather at the moment, but he's produced well in this round of big single punches. Smith still struggling to find his best form.
And he's not going to get a breather, Selby. Not against this opponent. If he needs a breather, he's going to be in trouble, because Smith will be on him. And Smith just trying to literally just overpower his opponent here.
He's just lunging, he's just throwing himself at Selby. I thought the work in the first couple of rounds scores it to Selby. Yep. The punches, the accurate shots, the powerful shots, the one you remember at the end of the round, again, seemed to come from Selby. Smith finished the round well, just by sheer work rate, but it wasn't really producing for the same quality. A couple of decent shots there, but I don't feel we saw enough of that from Smith in that round. But Selby, little signs that the pace is getting to him.
There's no way of knowing what is going to come next. We know what we're getting with Smith. He's had two tough 12-rounders and gone the distance and won. Selby has got to do as much again as he's already put in, and he's never been past six. Can he do it? Is he conditioned? Is he tough enough mentally?
Brilliant. Just be a little switch now. Will they start thinking what they're doing, try to drop the pace, try to bring skill in a little bit more? Or will that be a sign of weakness to the other guy if you drop the pace? It's just one of those kind of fights.
A right hand from Selby produces a spirited response from Swift. And once again, it's toe-to-toe stuff here in Liverpool. No quarter being asked or given. It's a slugfest.
Well, again, Smith coming forward, but really no quality there.
And the pace has definitely slowed a little bit in this seventh round. That'll suit Selby. I'm sure he'll be very grateful for a breather.
Switch to southpaw there now, Selby. He's actually boxing quite well. He's timing his punches. Smith just forcing himself forward without any real method.
Good right hand from Smith. One of the best punches he's landed in a while, but Selby comes back with decent shots of his own.
Just Smith is walking on to so many clean punches from Selby. There's not a thought in what he's doing. He's just throwing himself at Selby.
Well, if you're in Selby's camp right about now, you'd like to be seeing some of that awkward elusiveness that is his trademark. He needs to make Smith miss a few times, because Smith can just bore in and get in close and do that inside work, and that's where he's scoring, like that.
I still think Selby is landing the eye-catching punches. Now, that was good from Smith. Theo Smith has come forward all the way in this round, but not a lot of imagination, not a lot of method in what he's doing. Another round, really tough to score.
For me, Smith's just outworking Selby here in this round. And again, Selby looks to his corner.
That's always a bad sign. We've seen that before from him, but he gets himself back together again.
Selby needs a real good spell. And soon, just to slow Smith down if he can. He landed a decent left there, and Smith kind of felt that at the end. And again, we're getting the bravado with the right hand clenched and raised. But that was not a bad little left that Selby landed on the bell.
Big breaths, come on. Come on, you're miles better boxer than this lad, all right? Getting the job done, but you're walking with a few shots. Get the elbows tight, catch him, return him. That second jab, you've got to slow that second. One jab, two jab, and he's stepping back. And throw a third in and drive the right hand over. All right, he's moving two steps and standing still. You've got to move your feet three times. Two, step across, and then come with the right hand.
See, we're seeing good work from both men in every round, but a lot of the time, I've been impressed by the cleanness of the punches landed by Selby. Bang on the chin, bang on the target, whereas Smith is kind of scuffling forward, little short, jolting punches, not of the same quality. Did a lot of work in that round, which could have turned it in his favour, but every round is so tough to score now.
Yeah, they really are. And out they come again. Bombs away. Now, Jim, how are you reading this one?
Well, I've still got 1 point up at the moment. And he's boxing well at the moment. These are the tactics we expected to see from him. He's actually pushing Smith back. If he can do that, that would be a shock, certainly, for the Smith camp, if he can push him back.
He landed a good right upstairs, then switched to the body with the left hook. And I think he's got Smith hurt here, because Smith's backing up. And you don't see that very often. I thought he got tagged right at the end of that last round, Smith. He's certainly been caught a couple of times early in this next round as well, round eight.
Selby's turned to southpaw.
Good shot again.
Good shot. I hope it's not because he's injured the hand. I don't think it is. Now he's back to orthodox again.
But he's having real success here, Selby.
See, I just feel so many of the close rounds, Selby's are the punches that you remember at the end of it. They're long, they're accurate, and they're powerful looking, whereas Smith's up close, kind of spoiling his own work a little bit, just crowding himself. I love the
good
shot.
Right hand again. Really tasty shot. And Smith is starting to slow. And Selby is starting to grow in confidence. Smith needs to get a response, and quickly. This has not been a good round.
Smith hasn't produced anything like his best form in any of the rounds tonight. Sometimes when you feel that a fighter's not producing his best, then maybe he's losing the rounds, or some rounds he might be doing enough to nick it. But I don't think he's winning this round. This is good stuff from Lee Selby.
Another good single right hand, no head movement. Nothing, and he's finally got him. And he's not getting up from that. He's out cold. Gallagher was in the ring. What a shot. What a performance from Lee Selby. He came in confident, and he delivered. And Smith is in some distress here.
Just make sure young Smith is okay here. I think it's as much exhaustion as a tremendous finishing punch. As soon as that punch landed, it was over. Joe Gallagher jumped in. They'll just, as a precaution, they'll keep him lying on his back. I can see him speaking there. He's alert. I think he's just hurt, obviously. He'll be shattered psychologically, of course, but just as a precaution, they'll keep him on his back. They'll have oxygen standing by if it's needed. They're bringing the stool over now, because fighters always want to get up off the floor as soon as they can. But there are no signs of alarm.
That's great.
Looks as though he's okay.
Good to see. Good to see, and they put him on a stool. Well, there were signs that he was wearing down there. I think it started right at the end of the previous round when a really good left landed from Selby. Selby kept up the pressure in that last round, but the finish was sublime.
Yeah, well, Selby came out as if he knew. He started backing Smith up for the first time, moving forward with these punches. Tactics were the same as they were all through the fight. He was throwing big punches. Every single punch, he was looking for it to be a finisher. That must have shocked Smith. It must have shocked his camp. It was the opposite tactics to what they were expecting. But suddenly, he just looked stronger. He looked more experienced, and he took complete charge. I was still shocked when the ending came. It was a one-punch finish, but a tremendous performance from Lee Selby. Shocked everyone.
Smith looks okay, and that's great news. That's what we want to see. But I tell you, the unsung star of this one for me is the fellow just patting Smith on the back there. Tony Borg, the trainer of Lee Selby, got his tactics spot on. Well, let's look at that finish again. He wore him down slowly, and then when he was ready for the finish, did he deliver?
No, Smith was reckless all the way through. It was too easy to catch with punches, and boom! Shot caught him a little bit high, which scrambles the senses. And when you're really becoming exhausted as well, look at the way the legs collapsed from under him, and Selby standing over him, which we don't particularly like to see. But he knew by the force of that shot and the way Smith went down to the floor, it was over. So a little bit of bravado there, which you can't really blame him for.
And of course, Paul Smith in his dressing room will have been watching this as well. The other brothers are watching it, and yeah, there's Paul, and he would have known immediately that that was good night.
Yeah, well, he has to pick himself up. He has his own career to think about. But what a performance. He came to win a couple of titles here tonight. Nothing was going to budge him from that. I feel sorry for Smith. He didn't produce his best form at any time, but a lot of that was because he wasn't allowed to. Selby came with totally different tactics to what was expected. Macho all the way through, outfought Smith. But then you can see the difference in the faces, the damage that it's done. Tremendous performance from Lee Selby.
Well, it was interesting talking to Chris Sanagar, his manager, just there on the left. He said he's a cocky kid sometimes. He's got to back it up and deliver. I think he's got some talent.
Ladies and gentlemen,
at
2 minutes, 4 seconds of round eight, the fight has been stopped. The winner by technical knockout. And the new British and Commonwealth featherweight champion from Bury in Wales, Lee Selby.
And nobody can argue with that. He's getting generous applause here in Liverpool, where they know they're boxing. Selby came in to do a job, and he did it, and he's going home with those two belts.